Commonly used visuals are text, table, graphs, bar chart, and area chart. Let us start with text. Use text when you only have number or two that you want to communicate. This was to communicate a number, the net profit in 2021 to the board of directors. You may emphasize the statement by rephrasing, applying colors, and increasing font size. You may also add the source data details below the text. The follow-up question from the board was how to increase the profit in 2022 from operations. Here is the table that the management has prepared. From the table, it can be seen that selling tables resulted in loss consistently. In general, table interact with the verbal system, which means people need to read them. It is recommended to use light borders so that the number stands out. What else we can do to make it easier to read? How about applying colors using heat map? This adds visual cue that helps in bringing the audience attention to the number we want. You may increase the font size to make it easier to read. This looks good. What else can we do? Let's try graphs. Graphs are a quick way to communicate as they interact with our visual system. Let us start with a single series, just tables. Line graphs are effective in presenting trends over time. We can show double series, showing tables and copier, or multiple series of data. Multiple series is overwhelming, right? Let's simplify it by changing it to a slope graph. Let's look at only year 2020 and 2021, two time periods. Slope graph is best suited if we need to compare various categories between two time periods. The graph shows absolute values as well as the slope, the rate of change. You may add subcategory as labels. You may use visual cues to draw attention to your story. This looks better, right? Maybe the better way to present this data is to use a bar chart. It is suitable when information can be organized into groups. Few things to remember here. The bar chart must have zero baseline. Bar should be wider than the white space between the bars. Single, double, or multiple series are possible. But it gets harder to focus with multiple series. You may stack them to compare totals while seeing subcomponent of it. But it can be visually overwhelming. Let's focus only on 2021 and go back to the bar chart. Now the question is, should we present it in vertical or horizontal? It depends. For this particular case, horizontal bar chart is the best option. It is easy to read from left to right. In Tableau, we can create a calculated field. Let's add one for the profit margin. You may apply colors to communicate the point clearly. reorder them to emphasize the point. You may add labels close to the bar for easy visualization. And you may fit height. As you can see, horizontal bar chart is effective in this case. This chart not only communicates the profit, but as well as the profit margin from each operation, making it easier to decide where to downsize and where to invest. Area chart and pie chart are good to show numbers of vastly different magnitudes, but avoid using it if the difference between numbers is small, as it is hard to interpret. Next, let's create a waterfall chart to show the expected profit in 2022. Let's assume a positive impact of $30,546 by exiting table unit and an expected loss of $12,245 to clear existing tables. Every other unit performs the same way as in 2021. Let's add grand total and rename it as expected profit in 2022. Change it to a bar chart. Vertical bar chart is the most preferred option for a waterfall chart. Click Quick Table Calculation and select Running Total. Change it to Gantt bar. Move Cash Flow to the size mark and double click Cash Flow and add a negative sign. Click Show Row Grand Total. Let's add color to the chart. Include total and make it as two-stepped color. Red color indicates negative cash flow and blue color indicates positive cash flow. We can change the text size to make it clearly visible. The waterfall chart is ready. Just a few tips. Scatterplot can be used to show the relationship between two variables. Avoid secondary axes in a graph, as it takes time to understand which data should be read against which axis. When you're graphing time on horizontal axis, the data plotted must be in consistent intervals. See the difference between equal and unequal interval plots. Finally, avoid 3D charts as it skews the numbers and make it difficult to interpret. There are multiple ways to present the same data. As long as the visual communicates the story clearly, it is a good visual. Thank you. Learning is fun.